Hi, and welcome back to the See Havoy Engineering YouTube channel. The first supercomputer, Cray 1, had a computer storage of 8.39 megabytes, and this tiny device can store nearly 64,000 times its data, and can store it for a decade without electricity. So, how does this work? First, we'll see how the data is stored. Suppose there is a container that can store electrons. If currents pass, it stores electrons, and means zero. If not, it's empty and means one. If we head over to the drive, every USB has five key components that are essential for its functioning. The outer cover, which protects the internal circuitry and prevents it from getting any damage. Connector plug, the front part of the USB stick that plugs into the device. This USB drive has a USB-A connector. NAND flash memory chip. All of your files and data are stored here. Controller chip. This acts as an intermediate to help the USB drive communicate with the device it plugged into. Crystal oscillator. It works like a tiny clock inside a USB drive. Now, let's dive into the NAND flash memory chip. It is made of billions of tiny floating gate Mosfet transistors that store charge and thus enable data storage. The floating gate Mosfet is made of two gates. One is known as a floating gate, and the other is a control gate. Both are separated by dielectric material. The control gate is responsible for producing an electric field that attracts or repels the electrons. The floating gate acts as a container. It traps the electron, and the flash memory works by adding or removing an electron from the floating gate. When an electron is present in the floating gate, it means zero, and when absent, it means one. But how do we know if the electron is present in the floating gate MOSFET or not? Or how do we read the data? Well, when an electron is present, the threshold voltage is increased. Hence, the current cannot flow through the substrate, and the bit states a zero. When an electron is absent, the current flows through the transistor, and the bit states a one. This is how it reads the data. But how does it write the data? To store electrons, a relatively high voltage is applied across the transistor, which increases the velocity of electrons, and the electric field from the control gate traps electrons in the floating gates. To remove the electrons, the right amount of voltage is applied. When the electric field from the control gate pushes the electrons from the floating gate into the substrate. Writing and erasing have a destructive effect on flash memory cell, so it has limited read-write cycles. The flash memory has the following architecture. Thousands of these floating gates MOSFET transistors are arranged as a page. Then pages are stacked to form a block. Multiple blocks are used to read and write data simultaneously. Billions of these blocks make the NAND memory chip that stores thousands of your photos, videos, and songs for decades. I hope that you know now how a USB works. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this video, and watch the rest of my videos from my YouTube channel. Please also consider to support me on Patreon. Thanks very much. See you on the next video.